Namaste. Today, I am Dr. Asha Kiran. Have come up with lot of informations from Ayurveda, from nutritional aspect, from biochemistry, from health aspects about two most important vegetables largely utilized, largely thought, largely discussed, largely traded vegetables. Onion and garlic, who belong to the same family here. What is the Sanskrit name of onion? It is palandu. What about garlic? It is rasona. When we speak about garlic and onion, definitely the first question would come into your mind is whether it has been described in Ayurveda. Yes. There are a lot of discussions, lot of understanding, lot of thought have been done by the rishis of Ayurveda. Also, some religious sects in India, some vegetarians, some of these people, they do not prefer onion and garlic in their diet. That is their religious observations. What may be the reason? Let us understand all these in this session of video. What about the use of onion and garlic for weight gain or weight loss? Is it good for weight loss? Let us understand. First, we have to understand the properties of these both vegetables so that we will come to know whether this is good for what purpose, what not, what is there, what is not there in these. When it comes to onion or garlic, definitely the first thing will come into our mind is the bad breath which generates. We are all are afraid because when we go to office, when we go to schools, public places, in the morning itself, if we take raw onion or garlic, definitely after some time the mouth will start breathing very bad, odoring very bad. Why it is so? It is because there are few sulfur containing compounds called allicin and allicin methyl compounds, which are the reason. The sulfur containing compounds are the reason for this bad breath. Is there any way to avoid it? How it is happening? If we wash our mouth, will it go? It is difficult because the sulfur containing compounds, it enters into our stomach. From that, it doesn't get digested. It goes to the blood. From the blood, it enters to the lungs. And through the lungs, when we exhale, the sulfur containing compounds, they come out. So, in case of onion, it will start immediately. In case of garlic, it may take say 6 hours, 8 hours or even one day. So the next day also this bad odor, bad breath will remain. My guess is this is one of the reason why some of the religious sects, they understand this as tamasic, as something which is low in guna. Tamasa guna, sattva guna, rajo guna and tamo guna, something which is lower guna, tamasa, andhakara. But nutritional wise and in Ayurveda, garlic is considered as rasayana, something which is very good for rejuvenation, something which is very good for rejuvenation. And there is a story of how this garlic came into earth. In Ayurvedic texts, sometimes they explain this in the form of a story to underline the importance of things. We all know Amrita. Amrita, no? Amrita is there in the heaven. So, there is an instance of the Samudra Mathana. During the Samudra Mathana, we all know that one side Asuras were sitting, one side Devas were sitting. And Mahavishnu in the form of Mohini, he came and distributed this amrita. While distributing, this Rahu Swarbhanu, one asura, ate this amrita. Immediately Lord Mahavishnu cut his throat. One part became Rahu, one became Ketu. So that time what happened is, this Swarbhanu ate the amrita, he cut the throat. When he cut the throat, few of drops of this amrita fell into earth. Where it fell into some spider nets. This Rahu is an asura. Spider net is something with poison. After that from the drops, some plants originated. This is a story. It's a very interesting story. In that way, they gave it. So what happens? This is from Amrita Bindavaha, from the Amrita itself, the Alliyam, and from Ketu's drops, this onion has come up. Like that's the story. So, and because of that, the properties of Amrita, what is that which gives you long life, which gives rejuvenates the body, such benefits are present. Such detoxification, rejuvenation, aphrodisiac properties are there in onion and garlic. But because it has come from asuras, some dvijas, some religious sects doesn't, even it is noted in Ayurvedic text. I will read that. There is a very, 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 very interesting one shloka is there in Ashtanga Hridaya. This is Ashtanga Hridaya written by Vagbhatacharya long back, thousands of years ago. Sita vata hima dagdha tanunam stabdha magna kuti lavyathitas nam. Who has lost the interest in life. You know, in the olden days, they go to fight, they go to wars and battles, and they get hurt. Such people also, they can take this garlic and get rejuvenated. Bheshajasya bhavano pahatanam vakshyate vidhirato lashunasya. With this garlic. Raho ramrta chauryena lunadye patita galat amrtasya kana bhumau te raso natvamagataha dvija nashnanti tamaso daitya deha samudbhavam tamasaha. Because it has some tamasic guna, some Brahmins, they don't eat this. Sakshad amrta sambhuter gramani sarasayanam. But Ayurveda considers it as a one thing which is very useful for rejuvenating, improving our health. Shilaye lashunam shite. Because it is hot in potency, in the cold climate, it has to be utilized, not in summer. Not in the summer, it is not flavored. Ghanodaye pivatarthaha sadava grishma lilaya snigdha shuddha tanu. Lot of ghee, lot of oils has to be taken. Lubrication should be done when you go for taking this garlic. That is very important. Taduttam savatam samyam charchita nuchara jiraha. Then if you take like that, what will happen? Your life will, you will become healthy, you will live long. This is the promise of Ayurveda for taking garlic. Then it is pain killing also. It is pain killing also. So very lot of uses are there described for this garlic and onion. Now you will see, what about, see, usually those who are lot of conscious about weight and all usually take this garlic and onion. They think that garlic and onion doesn't increase the weight, but Ayurveda says that they are brahmana, they increase the body size, they increase the weight. So this is a message is there for those who want to reduce your weight. You can better avoid this garlic and onion, or you can use less. Don't think that, oh, I am using lot of things and I am using garlic and it is hot in potency, so it may, you know, reduce my weight. No, in according to Ayurveda, they may not reduce the weight, because they all are in sweet in their taste. So lashuno brishati kshno shna katupa karasa saraha
Hridya Keshyo, it is good for hair, hair growth. Guru Hu, Vrishyaha, it is good for, good as a aphrodisiac, it is good for infertile people. This is good actually. Snigdho Rochana Deepanaha, Shwasakasan Hanti Rasayanam, Palandus Tadgunan Nyunaha, Shleshmalo Na Ati Pittalaha, Shleshmalaha, something which increases the body fluids, so it retains the body fluids. Because of that, our weight may gain, it may not go down. This is in Ashtanga Hridaya. What about in Bhava Prakasha? Let us see. In Bhava Prakasha, Lashunastu Rasonasya Dugragandho Mahaushadham Arishtom Lechedakandascha Yavanesto Rasonakaha. Then he says that पंचभिश्च रसैर्युक्तो रसो रसेन अम्लेन वर्जितः इट इज नॉट एसिडिक एज वी ऑल थिंक रसो नो ब्रह्मणो वृष्यः ब्रह्मणः भाव प्रकाश हैज क्लियरली सेड इट इज ब्रह्मण गार्लिक इज ब्रह्मण समथिंग विच इंक्रीजेस द बॉडी वेट सो दोज हु वांट टू अवॉइड बॉडी वेट प्लीज यूज लेस अमाउंट ऑफ गार्लिक Balavarnakaro Medha, it is good for increasing the memory, IQ, etc. Netriyo Rasayanaha, Hridroga Jirna Jvara Kukshishula Vibandha Gulma Ruchikasa Shophan Durnama Kushtha Nalasa Dajantu Samirana Shvasa Kapham Chahanti. It is good for respiratory tract infections, such kind of situations and all. Garlic and onion are good. And this one name of onion itself is Mukha Dushakaha, something which spoils the breath of, you know, mukhvas. You know, there are a lot of importance given for flavors of for the face, for the mouth. This is called Mukha Dushakaha, something which creates bad breath. Swadu Pake, when you boil it, when you digest it, it becomes sweet in potency. Raseno Shnaha, it is Ushna Virya. Kapha Grinnati Pittalaha, it supports Kapha. Kapha is something with body weight, so body weight increases. Harate Kevalam Vatam, it pacifies the pain, it pacifies the dryness, it pacifies weakness, tiredness. Balavir Yakaro Guruhu, it is difficult to digest. These are the general aspects of this garlic and onion. So from all this, what we have to take home, what is the take home message, is we should not take too much of onion and garlic or too less of it. We can take it, it is not so, and it is very praised in Ayurveda. Ayurvedic Rishis, Ayurvedic Vaidyas were knowing the properties of garlic and onion. They have taken, they have said how to, in which condition you have to avoid, which condition you have to utilize, like that. Both are good for winter season, when cold in climate, like that, but not in, during the summer season or where you know a lot of hot. Especially this garlic is advised for those non-vegetarians, those alcoholic people and all. Garlic is a prescribed thing by Ayurveda. Now, one hint, how can we try to avoid the bad breath? If we take raw coriander leaves after taking or along with the onion or garlic, to some extent we can avoid this bad breath, but not to completely, to some extent. So these are about the garlic and onion. If you have any doubt about this garlic and onion, you can come with your doubts. I will try to clarify from Ayurvedic point of view or scientific point of view. Let us have a discussion. I am Dr. Asha Kiran. We have a hospital, Takshana Ayurveda Hospital at Yashwantpur, Bangalore. Along with my wife, Dr. Manasa Bhatt, we do treat a lot of patients with a lot of health issues such as diabetes, obesity, weight, weight gain, weight loss issues, thyroid, PCOD, infertility, arthritis, psoriasis. We have a lot of panchakarma techniques. We have take home panchakarma kit detoxification. We have been doing a lot of research and we have developed a product called Immuna. I will show you Immuna. This Immuna. this immune up is something which is for immunity boosting. So we have such a lot of products also. If you have any doubts in Ayurveda, if you have any health issue, if you want to get a treatment, if you want to have a teleconsultation, please contact us. We will try to help you. Thank you.